Hello viewers, this is Prasanna. In this video, I am going to explain you 2.5 in unit 2 fractions, decimal and rational numbers. In the first question, which one is greater? So observe this, 0.7 or 0.07, which is greater? Here decimal after one number is there, here decimal after two numbers, it is clearly that they are not in live decimal fractions. So we have to convert into live decimal fractions by keeping zeros at the last. Here you can write this as how 0.070 and here 0.07. Now compare first whole part. What is the whole part here? 0 and 0. So they are equal. Right? Next. Compare after decimal tens place. Here is 7, here is 0. Which is greater? 7 is greater. Then I can say this is greater. Is it clear? Now coming to second one. 7 and 8.5. Here what is the whole part in this? 7. Here 8. Which is greater? 8 is the greater. Then 8.5 is greater. So here is coming to third one, 1.47 and 1.51. Here they are in live decimal fractions. Here decimal after two numbers, decimal after two numbers. Now first we will compare whole part. What is the whole part here? 1. Coming to here 1. So they are equal. Coming to next, what is the tens place? 4. Here what is the tens place? 5. Which is greater? 5 is greater. So this one is greater. 1.51 is greater. Coming to here, 6 and 0.66. What is the whole part here in this 6? 6. 6 can be written as 6.000, so on. The value doesn't change. Here 6 and coming to here, what is the whole part? 0. Which is greater? 6 is greater. So here 6 is greater. Coming to second question, express the following as rupees using decimals. In the first one, they are given 9 pies. They are given in pies. You have to convert into rupees. And you people know that 1 rupee is nothing but 100 pies. Then what about 1 pies? 1 pies is nothing but 1 by 100 rupees. So 1 pies is nothing but 1 by 100 rupees. Coming to here, they are given 9 pies. So you have to write rupees 1 by 9 by 100. 1 pies 1 by 100. 2 pies 2 by 100. 3 pies 3 by 100. Similarly 9 pies 9 by 100. So 9 by 100 convert into decimal. Here they are 1. In the denominator 2 zeros are there. So after decimal you should get 2 numbers. So for this you have to keep point and 0, 9. This is rupees 0.09 is the answer. Coming to 77 rupees 7 pies. Here 77 is in rupees. We have to convert this pies into rupees. So 77 as it is you write, and you write 7 pies as 7 by 100. Because you know 1 pies is 1 by 100 rupee. Similarly so 7 pies 7 by 100. Now how we write this is 77 is a whole part. 0.7 by 100 gives you 0.07. So answer is rupees 77.07. Coming to here 235 pies. Here 1 pies is 1 by 100 rupees. So 235 pies is 235 by 100 rupees. Okay. So rupees here decimal after how many you should keep here? 1 after 2 zeros are there. So decimal will come from right to left after 2 places. So 2.35. So rupees 2.35 is the answer. Coming to third one. Express 10 centimeters in meters and kilometers. They are asking you to express the centimeters in meters and kilometers. And first you know that 1 meter is nothing but 100 centimeters. Right? Now 1 meter 100 centimeters, then what about 1 centimeter? 1 by 100 meters. Okay? Now here we will do. So first part I am going to convert 10 centimeters into meters. Right? Now 10 centimeters meters, how 1 centimeter is 1 by 100 meters, so 10 centimeters is nothing but 10 by 100 meters. 10 by 100 means how much? You cut 0 and 0, you get 1 by 10 meter. 1 by 10 means how much? 0.1 meter. Right? Coming to next, here one more thing you have to remember children, when you are converting smaller quantity into bigger quantity, you have to divide. When you are converting bigger to smaller, you have to multiply. Right? Now coming to next, second part is 10 centimeters we have to convert into kilometers, right? Before that we have to see 1 kilometer is how many centimeters. If you are getting confusion, just you know, everyone know that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. Yes, now convert that meters into centimeters. 1000 into 1 meter, how many centimeters here? 100 centimeters. Okay, so 1000 into 100 gives you 1 lakh centimeters. So 1 kilometer is nothing but 1 lakh centimeters. Now I want 1 centimeter equal to how many kilometers in reverse? So 1 by 1 lakh kilometers. Right? Now here we apply this in the second part. So 10 centimeter equal to how many kilometers? Here 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 1 lakh kilometers. Then 10 centimeter is equal to how many? 10 by 1 lakh kilometers. If you cancel 0, 0, you will get 1 by 10,000 kilometers. How to convert this into decimal? Here down how many zeros are there? 4 zeros means for 1 you have to keep decimal. 4 zeros means decimal after 4 numbers should be there. So 0 point, here 0, 0, 0 and this is 1 kilometers. Here 4 zeros means decimal after 4 numbers. So 10 centimeters is nothing but 0.0001 kilometers. In the second one, express 45 millimeters in centimeters, meters and kilometers. First part is we will convert 45 millimeters into centimeters, right? Now you know the relation between centimeters and millimeters. Yes, 1 centimeter is nothing but 10 millimeters. Then what about 1 millimeter then? 1 by 10 centimeters. Here you have to apply this. Okay. Now 1 millimeter is equal to 1 by centimeters. 2 millimeters is equal to 2 by 10 centimeters. Similarly 45 millimeters is how much? 45 by 10 centimeters. 45 by 10 means you will get 4.5 centimeters. So 45 millimeters is nothing but 4.5 centimeters. Coming to second one, we have to convert 45 millimeters into meters. Okay. Now we will see the relation. Here you may get confused how 1 meter, how many millimeters. But you know perfectly that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Yes. Now here we convert these centimeters into millimeters. Here 1 centimeter is how many millimeters? 10 millimeters. So here in place of 10 centimeters, I write 10 millimeters. 1 centimeter. In place of 1 centimeter, I write 10 millimeters. Now 100 into 10, how much? 1000 millimeters. Okay. So 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeters. Now I want 1 millimeter is equal to how many meters? 1 by 1000 meters. Here we are converting millimeters into meters. Similarly, here 45 millimeters is nothing but 45 by 1000 meters. Now 45 by 1000 means how much? Here down 1 after 3 zeros are there. So decimal after 3 numbers should come. But here 45 only 2 numbers are there. So here I write for 0.045 meters. In this third part is we have to convert 45 millimeters into kilometers. First we see the relation between kilometers and millimeters. You know perfectly that 1 kilometer is nothing but 1000 meters, right? Now I will convert this meters into centimeters first. Here 1000 into 1 meter, how many centimeters? 100 centimeters. So how much you will get here? 1000 into 100 is nothing but 1 lakh centimeters. But I want in millimeters. Just now I discussed 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeters. So 1 lakh into 10 millimeters. In place of centimeter, I am writing 10 millimeters. So 1 lakh into 10 gives you 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs means 1 after 6 zeros. So 1 kilometer is nothing but 10 lakh millimeters. Then what about 1 millimeter? 1 by 10 lakh kilometers. Now we will apply that formula here. Okay, 45 millimeters is nothing but 45 by 10 lakhs kilometers. Here 10 lakhs means 1 after how many zeros? 6 zeros. But we are having only 2 numbers here. That means decimal after 6 numbers should come. So for this one, I will keep 0.00004 zeros I will keep because other 2 numbers are 4, 5. So 145 millimeters is nothing but 0.000045 kilometers. Coming to fourth question, express the following in kilograms. Here they are given in grams, here also grams. We have to convert into kilograms. First we will write the relation between kilograms and grams. You know, 1 kg is nothing but 1000 grams. But here we have to convert this grams into kilograms. When you are converting smaller to bigger, we have to divide. Then what about 1 gram? 1 by 1000 kg. Okay, this we have to remember. So 1 kg 1000 grams, then 1 gram is equal to 1 by 1000 kg. Now 190 grams is nothing but 190 by 1000 kg. Okay, so 0 you can cut here. So 19 by 100 kg. How much you will get? 1 after 2 zeros answer, so 0.19 kg is the answer. Right? Coming to here, 247 grams. Same. Here, 1 gram is 1 by 1000 kgs. So, 247 grams is nothing but 247 by 1000 kg. Now, here 2, 3 zeros are there. So, 0.247 kg is the answer. Right? Coming to next one, 44 kg, 80 grams. Here, they are given 44 in kg. We have to convert this 80 grams into kgs. So, 44 as it is, you have to write. In here, 80 by 1000, you should write. You are converting 80 grams into kgs. Now, 44.80 by 1000, how do you write, children? Here, 1 after 3 zeros are there. But in the numerator, only 2 numbers are there. So, 080 kg is the answer.